Hi Libra, welcome to your end of February 2024 general tarot update. It's Raina here. I'm just starting over again because I turned on another lamp just to give additional lighting. And so that's why the cards are already laid out. The heart of the matter is the judgment card. You can see this kind of tracing, which this can be I guess you could say like the higher self, but also a part of us that is a higher vibrational version of ourselves. The judgment card can be rebirth, in other words. But since I started the reading earlier, I said, you know, this eclipse that's going to be in your sign is happening in the latter part of March. But you may actually feel that impact in February for some people, a month earlier. And this is going to be in your first house of the self. So it's really like about purging this way that you have been. For some people, this may be in the 12th house. And even in the 12th house, I really see a kind of a parallel between the first and the 12th. The only difference is that it's more externalized in the first house because it's the outer version of yourself, your mannerisms, you know, how you present yourself to others, how you behave with other people. The 12th house can be more of the stuff inside, like any kind of self-destructive patterns, addictions, and also that you need to let go of in order to kind of be reborn, because I think this is so common. But even in the first house, I could see the same kind of things more in an overt way, where people, they want to change, but they don't know where to start. And when you have a lunar eclipse in your sign, this can be a way, kind of like a blessing to assist you in dropping certain things without it having to be that big of a deal, because that's why people don't do it. A lot of times it's so hard for them to do it. And the other thing that the judgment card can be about is an actual legal judgment that you're awaiting. At the time of the any lunar eclipse or full moon, this is like a heightened full moon. The sun is in the opposite sign, in the opposite house, which means in this case, in Aries, it's in your, the seventh house is the house of committed partnership. So there could be something that, you know, is triggering to a relationship. And it's like part of it is you seeing your part in it. And it doesn't always have to be like, oh my God, the relationship's going to end. If you have a basically good relationship and there just have been some issues lately, then it can simply be an adjustment where you realize that you have been doing certain things that have contributed to the issue. A lot of times Libra may say, but I try to do everything. I try to give in. I try to, you know, be what that person wants me to be. Well, that could be the very thing that is effed up, because, you know, you are supposed to be authentic. And if you don't want to do something and you say yes to it anyway, what does that mean? That means that you're doing something that you really are going to be resentful about. And it's not that other person's fault, just because they asked you. Maybe they really thought that you would want to do it. And if you are like, no, I don't want to do this, they might be very surprised to hear that, because they thought that you were, you know, they didn't know. So the other thing too So when I say legal, it could be like a legal judgment if you're getting divorced, for instance, but also anything to do with your own judgment. If you judge somebody that was not who they claim to be, and you're like kicking yourself, why did I do that? Well, there's a reason why we do what we do, and we don't have to beat ourselves up for it. We can just chalk it up to, living and learning, right? And in the past position, we have the Eight of Cups, and this is walking away from what no longer serves you. And it really has this connotation with someone who is maybe on a spiritual quest, and they are they're being more aware of what is fulfilling to them and what isn't. Libra is an air sign, so it's easy for you to get in your head and not be in touch with your actual feelings and to kind of rationalize them, make them abstract. And I can relate, having the moon in Virgo myself, and it can get a little bit, I don't know. The word I was looking for, I was thinking of like contrived, where it's like you're trying to feel something, but you're not. But it's really like the cups are water energy, so it is about the emotions and feeling them. Sometimes what has worked for me has been music, has been that opens up my heart chakra. So I'll be walking down the street and I'll just be, bawling my eyes out, wearing headphones and bawling my eyes out. I'm like, oh, is anybody seeing me crying like this? And I was just thinking about that today because sometimes I don't listen to music at all. And then, because I don't really, I'm not in that mood. And I mean, I'm talking about music that makes me cry. I listen to music for other reasons. But, sometimes it feels very cathartic and it can just open up your heart like big time. And it's funny because I was just thinking today about how I was listening to a song by Laura Nyro, and that I, and I hadn't listened to it for a while, and I started crying, and I was thinking, gosh, it's so wonderful when we have the this we have things like art to inspire us and to open our hearts when we feel uninspired and maybe unemotional, and get into that and tap into that. And this can also be about career moves, because the Eight of Cups to me is like something that just leaves you feeling empty, that you're doing that is not what you really want to be doing, but you kind of don't know how to get there. The Judgment card could be like you're in this process of rebirth, but it's a messy process. It's not something that happens overnight. So it's one of those things where you have to have patience with yourself. And sometimes when we want to change, we may have been in this what do you call it, like stagnant rut type of a thing for a long time, and then all of a sudden we're like, oh man, I really want to change. But then it's like we want to change overnight. And it becomes too much in the other direction. It's a little bit silly, you know. The higher message is a temperance card, and this card is connected to the sign of Sagittarius. In the higher message position, I'm not necessarily interpreting it in the conventional way. I'm looking at the spiritual lesson in this. And I was just saying in another reading yesterday that I always have thought that the temperance card should be Libra, because it is about balance, and it's about the spiritual and the material, heaven and earth. If you see, he's like an earth angel. He's got wings and he's got these construction boots, which really are the earthy part, but the ethereal wings, And it's like it's funny too, because when I think of a sign like Libra, I think of ethereal. I think of somebody who doesn't necessarily want to touch the earth, because air energy is above it all. And it almost feels like too coarse and too dirty and too base. Air is so much lighter. So when this is happening, what it is really, telling us in the higher message is that it's like we're not just one thing. We're not just human beings living a limited amount of years, and then we die, and we just spend that time working to keep our bodies alive. That would be the complete materialist who doesn't believe in anything beyond the physical. And then you have the spiritual person who is like, talking about I'm a multidimensional being and blah, blah, blah. And they're saying all this stuff, but they're not grounded. And because of that, they can make some really foolish decisions. The judgment card can be, why did I do that? That was stupid. And I would have to say, because of the Eight of Cups, that would usually be something to do with a relationship that you're walking away from and that, like, you don't feel it. And maybe you never did, but I do believe with the Eight of Cups that the person believed in something for a while, and then it became something that made him feel empty. But who knows? I mean, sometimes in those situations, they may have just not known who they were, so they didn't know that there was anything more than that. When you have a spiritual awakening, it's like, think more things become open to you about life. And I haven't had anything like some other people have talked about. I think it will vary from person to person what your spiritual awakening will look like. And I actually think there are more than one, or you could say phases. So I don't think there's just this one thing and then that's it. I think you have different levels that you ascend to, where you start to understand more. And you can entertain more information, more abstract level. But the thing is that we still have to have that groundedness. We can't just be, living life in the upper chakras. And so that can sometimes lead to doing things that, it's almost like getting misled in a way that is, you assume is like spiritual, like people saying, well, I was told to do this, but who knows, what prompted you to do that? If it was really, your higher self or what do they call them? Spirit guides. It could be some other entity or some other something infiltrating or, trying to convince you to do something that isn't really in your best interest. So, but even just like society, encourages us to do things that are not necessarily in alignment with our true desires. What crosses you is the Ten of Pentacles. This is a card that's connected to money at a higher level, but affluence and, I think this can be like a, what do you call it? Kind of like a blockage that keeps you from achieving more things because you're so afraid of losing that lifestyle. Like if you have a partner or a spouse who is making a very nice living and you don't feel, you feel empty inside regarding the relationship, but the money is what makes it hard to like walk away from it. And of course a job as well. Then that could be the dilemma. I get this card a lot and I think I do because I think that this is a very big issue for a lot of people. And I always feel like I'm saying things in such a mundane way and I'm being repetitive, but I think that maybe it's good for me to talk about these things because I think that people get misled about what is true security, what is true, are you happy if you have more money than you need, but you're miserable getting up every day? Is that really a great trade-off? There's some people who lose their money for whatever reason, and they had a lot of it. I was I can't, I wish I I wish I could remember these things that I read, but I remember this person said they were happier than they had ever been because they were just so profoundly unhappy doing what they were doing that they didn't mind that they had next to nothing. They were living, maybe they were living in a one room, studio apartment versus a big house and all of that, but they felt so much more relieved than that they had gotten away from that situation. So keep that in mind. And also the ten of Pentacles to me, like for love situations, can be that sense of continuity, that sense of generations. So you may know if you're somebody, for instance, who is at the age where you want to start a family, and you're with somebody that you know is not who you want to do that with, then it's like you know that it's. I hesitate to use the word hopeless, but what I mean is that it's not going to work. And so it can be very difficult to realize that because you know that it means that you have to do something else that is kind of the unknown, and that can be very difficult. It's interesting. I got what is coming in, the King of Pentacles. So this is actually someone who is very financially astute. It could be a financial planner, an investment banker. And this kind of person, another thing about the Ten of Pentacles is it's a card of family money. So sometimes there might be like that's the inheritance card, the Ten of Pentacles, and so maybe there's some kind of probate issue or will that is not going in your favor. And you may be like the black sheep of the family. And you have, like with the Eight of Cups, I can see somebody that kind of walked away from that group dynamic. And maybe people hated on you for that. Usually Libra will not do that. You will usually go along to get along, but there might have been some reason why you just had enough. Again, if you're having a spiritual awakening, you can see the differences between you and other people, and it can feel unbearable, whereas before it just was par for the course. So the king can represent the father. Maybe this is where the money has, the source of the money, or when I say father, it could be like a stepfather, father figure, who is stepping in, or even from beyond, from the great beyond, and giving you this advice. Oh, yeah, I said great beyond, and then I get the outcome, the High Priestess. So the High Priestess is right under the Temperance card, and this is kind of what I was referring to. I would say, and you can see the crown chakra and all that energy going up there. I'm trying to think here. Some of you, I'm just thinking astrologically, you have Uranus in your eighth house, so that can be the spontaneous, even the Kundalini activation, that I think that's associated with Uranus and the nervous system and everything like that, or something along those lines. That's like a supernatural experience that happens suddenly. That's why I say Kundalini, because that's typically what I have heard, that a person just has sometimes their kundalini ascends, it's like, you know, the energy that's coiled at the base of the spine and it shoots up. But for some people, it can be very sudden. Some people do practices to make that happen, but some people, it might be a spontaneous thing. And Uranus is definitely spontaneous. But also Neptune in the sixth house, which can be about work. This may be something that you feel called to do, and that will just naturally change, you know, create a cascade of events that leads to other things happening that are connected to your spirituality. And it can feel very discombobulating if you're someone who is new to all of this. And it just, it blows my mind. Like, I'm following somebody who had their awakening, I think in 2017, and they're like full blown into all kinds of spiritual services. And I think to myself, I mean, I started my channel. I started doing this in 2015, and this person didn't even have their awakening until 2 years later. And they're just like holding workshops, doing the, you know, traveling around the world and, you know, having a booked client list and all this stuff. So it can happen really quickly. You can get these downloads. But anyway, yeah, that's probably what that is. That picture, she's getting a download. As an outcome card, it's like team spirit. Like, if we're talking about the Temperance card, we're talking about the spiritual versus the material, which one wins out? So Ten of Pentacles is in the challenge position. Pentacles relate to earth energy. And so sometimes the temptations are there to focus on the material, but sometimes that's not where you're headed or where you're at. And so for sure, this can be a time when there's great transformation taking place within you and without you, Libra. Okay, that's what I have for you. I hope that this resonated. If you would like an astrology reading with me, I have a package deal called my Deep Dive, Hour of Natal Chart Analysis, Hour of Transits for the next 12 months for a special price. And I have a couple of other package deals as well, including the tarot. And I also have standalone readings like love readings and career readings. You can find out more information at the link below. I'm at rainamoonastrology.com. Thanks for watching. Bye.